Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. What's going on? Well, I'm just on my travels again at the moment. I'm just having a few days away with my good lady in the Lake District in the UK. We're at the side of Lake Coniston at the moment. We found a legal camping spot for the night, so we're in the camper van enjoying a nice view this evening. But I want to talk about what happened last weekend. I'm just trying to get a bit of a video edit together while we're on this trip. From weekend just gone, and I went trail riding in Wales with some guys I know, Dean, Tony and Alex. They're from the Kent area, known the guys a couple of years now, and they kindly invited me on a trail riding weekend with them in Wales. Now Dean organised the trip with the local Trail Riders Fellowship, the TRF, and he linked in with a guy called Howell Thomas, really nice chap, put us up for the weekend. Honestly, just the hospitality was unbelievable. I still slept in the camper van though, in the driveway, but we had, you know, the use of the house for eating and everything else, and it was really nice of him to do that for us. And he took us out on some fantastic trails on the Saturday and the Sunday. Now, it's got to be said, there were a few little incidents on the weekend. For one, Alex couldn't get his bike started on Saturday morning. Turned out to be a battery issue on his 2019 Husky TPI, so he didn't ride on Saturday, but he managed to ride it on Sunday when he borrowed one of Howell's bikes, one of his old KTMs. So yeah, a good ride out on Saturday. The weather was a bit mixed, but a little bit of rain in places. We met some of the locals, herded a few sheep, that sort of thing. And then on Sunday we went down further south from Newtown, because we were stopping in the Newtown area. We're about 25 miles from Newtown south. Met up with a couple of guys who took us out, and we did about an 80 mile trail ride on Sunday. The weather was fantastic on Sunday, really nice, sunny, and the scenery was just absolutely fantastic. As far as the GPX went, no problem at all with the GPX until the last ride, well, last hour or so. I went through a deep water splash. I think I sucked a little bit of water into the carburettor. We had a bit of a moment where the bikes came to a stop. We pulled the choke, got the bike going again. So it obviously got water into the fuel sort of system. I think it got sucked up through the breather tubes. So I checked the air filter when I got home, and that was the air filter was clean as a whistle. So it must have been some water sucked into the breather tubes to carb. So we're going to run them into the air box now. But other than that, the GPX ran great. We had one little lie down on Saturday, ended up in a rut, took a bit of a snooze there. And when I was in that rut, I could see Tony riding up, saying, Robbo, stay there, thinking about, you know, he's concerned about my welfare, and, you know, if I'm hurt or anything like that. I mean, I did take a bit of a bruise when I did end up in that sort of situation. But me thinking Tony's sort of, you know, thinking about my welfare, all he's bothered about is taking a photograph of me while I'm in the rut laid down the ground. So, yeah, I'll get him back at some point. Well, he got his comeuppance the following day because he took his bike into some deep water and he sucked some water and it was like chocolate milkshake in his airbox.
First time Tony's bike's ever been on one wheel. Fuck off! Don't put it on YouTube.
Another Tiny Man Dingo. Oh,
Go on, I got a clutch here.
Go on, try that.
Oh. Oh dear. Tony just wringing out his air filter.
And that was his day over. We've got the bike running initially, but then it cut out again. So I think the bike's in need of an engine rebuild now from having taken water in the cylinder. So that's it from me at the side of Lake Coniston on this nice sunny Thursday evening in the UK. I'm now going to leave you with some clips from last weekend. So stay tuned, Hard Enduro and Adventure Media at Eurotech and on Robbo's GPX dirt bike page. See you soon, guys.
I thought he's f***ing me, you're having some.
Hold on, my bike is there.
Yeah. Oh, little lamb. Larry the lamb. Yeah. Back to your mum.
He said you disturbed my afternoon snooze.
Yeah, she couldn't see it, could she? Because he's in a dip, she couldn't see him.
Some water and
bolt out. Just don't touch the throttle, just hit the button. You got water and electrics, haven't you? That's what you've done, I think. Have you pulled the air filter?
Not right out, no.
No.
You've taken the cover off.
Yeah, but you need to look in the, just make sure it's not.
Next time, Nike, I'd
steak pegs.
Thinking of buying a toothpick, mate. I'll have a word with you, Jordan.
Al, can you lay your hands on Alan, please, mate?
Yeah. Sorry, what did you ask me?
Yeah, I bet you've taken a bit of water in the filter. Oh, we need to get the air filter.
Sure.
Need to get the air filter off.
Yeah.
Tip it up.
Well, to be fair,
you did take it to the fucking lake. That'll be alright, honestly.
Yeah. How deep is that?
P&O Ferries thought I was in competition with them.
I could look for my canal boat into that puddle.
Don't think you could, mate.
With what engine, you see? Oh,
you're a fucking madman. It is nothing lunatic.
How deep is it?
Yeah, that's deep.
That's deep enough.
Deep enough, innit?
Yeah.
You always pull protection before you ride through it. Always.
Yeah, I saw that and thought, no, fuck that shit.
Yeah. I'm saying this is the funniest we've ever seen this.
You're joking, mate. I said to you. Yeah.